What's poppin' YouTube, and welcome to my channel, Astro Finesse. It's your boy Lil Finesse Jiggy Hippie, back with another video for y'all. And in this video right here, it's if you have a Mercury in Gemini. And I'll pause for the cause. If you don't know what your Mercury sign is, if you don't know what a Mercury sign is, we're in 2019 going on to 2020. If you still to this point don't understand how important it is to learn about yourself through astrology and numerology, don't worry, I got you. There's a couple of videos. I'll put the link in the description. You got to watch them first to become hip to the knowledge of what I'm about to talk about right now. So if you looked at your birth chart or your natal chart, it's the same thing. And you realize that your Mercury sign is in Gemini, this video is for you. So without further ado, let's just get it popping, shall we? Now you already know, before I start, I'm going to give y'all a list of some celebrities so y'all can visually see what Mercury and Gemini people look like and act like in reality. So to start, we got Marilyn Monroe, Angelina Jolie, Andre 3000, Prince, Chris Brown, Tupac, Adele, Nikola Tesla, Russell Brand, 50 Cent, Lauryn Hill, Post Malone, Paula Abdul, and Audrey Hepburn. All right, so boom, Gemini Mercury. First of all, let's have like a little recap of what we talked about so far on this astrology channel. Talk about your sun sign, which is your ego, like your core energy, your brand name, so to speak. Your moon sign is your emotions. The rising sign is how you physically present yourself to the world, how people perceive you off of first impression. The Venus sign is how what you're attracted to, what you like to spend your money on, what you find value in. The Mars sign is your action, how you like to go about getting that attraction, your passion, your drive. And now Mercury is your communication planet. How you intellectualize things, how you communicate with people, how you learn and analyze things with your mind. So the Moon is how you feel, Mercury is how you think. So having a Gemini Mercury, understand that, first of all, we all know that Geminis are very quick-witted. Geminis are very restless. Geminis like to always put their hand in different baskets, love to multitask. Geminis like to chat a lot, very communicative like that. And having Mercury in Gemini, Mercury is exalted in Gemini because Mercury rules Gemini and Virgo. So we're talking about Gemini right now. So Mercury is exalted in this placement. So what does that mean? If you have a Mercury in Gemini, understand that you have A1 communication skills. You have A1 skills of the way you can use your words to get what you want. You have a good way of analyzing things quickly, like extremely quickly. You have a way of grasping information and keeping it inside, like grasping, like, I'm not gonna say useless information, but I'll just say like everyday information that people don't really like care about. Y'all really grasp information from everywhere and anywhere and just like keep it in your mental and like randomly just spit out facts to people. Like, y'all just love to grasp information. Y'all are very intelligent people. Air energy is intelligence. Water energy is intuition. Earth energy is practicality. And then fire energy is like adrenaline, or it's like action, basically. So having an air Mercury, y'all are very talented with your communication skills. Now, there's the good and bad to everything, like I said. Before I even go about that, Mercury likes to go with the sun, doesn't like to go too far away from the sun. It moves with the sun in the solar system. So if you have a Gemini Mercury, understand that your sun sign is going to be either Gemini, Taurus, or Cancer. Mercury doesn't like to move too far away from the sun. So if you have like a Taurus sun with a Gemini Mercury, you're going to be less rigid. You're going to be less stubborn, slightly less stubborn. I'm not going to say all that. You're going to be slightly less stubborn because Gemini is mutable. Gemini likes to, is like very open-minded, kind of free, so likes to do different things a lot. So you're not going to be too like stuck in your way like that, like a regular Taurus. If you have a Gemini with a Gemini Mercury, you're like a super, super Gemini. So like Gemini energy is flowing all through your energy type thing. If you have a Cancer with a Gemini Mercury, you're going to be more susceptible to communicating your feelings rather than keeping it inside. Like, Cancers are very emotional. Their mood changes a lot. So having a Gemini Mercury with a Cancer sun, you're going to be more susceptible to communicating out your feelings and how you feel about things easier, because Gemini just makes communication for y'all flow easy. like I said, Mercury is exalted in Gemini. So that means that when it comes to communication, it flows out natural for y'all. Words just come in your head and just comes out natural. So Gemini Mercury people are extremely, let me start off by saying they are extremely intelligent. Extremely intelligent. Look at Nikola Tesla. Like, he has invented a lot of things. Like, he has like changed the world in a way, in his own way, with his inventions, and like his mind has always been advanced. Like, Gemini Mercury people have advanced intelligence because Geminis are always grasping information from every which way. Gemini in general does not like to sit still. So having that energy in your mind, in the Mercury, in your intelligence, in your communication, your mind will never sit still, because your mind always has to analyze things and compute things, and you're gonna always be good at, you're gonna always talk a lot too, obviously, but it's like y'all just love to grasp information a lot. Like a hobby for y'all is just reading articles and newspapers and like whatever y'all like, whatever you're interested in, y'all are actually interested in reading and like taking in information about anything and everything. Gemini is a jack of all trades, but a master of none. So that means that like they have so many different interests a lot. They do so many different things. When it comes to the Mercury, your intelligence, y'all could be interested in so many different things and actually learn about so many different things. But the patience that y'all have is not enough for y'all to really focus on one thing to be a master at it. But instead, you will learn about this. You learn a lot about this. And like as soon as, like before you get to the mastery level, y'all low-key get bored and go to something else and learn a lot about that. And before you get to the mastery level, you will get bored and go to something else. So like y'all are always learning about something different. Y'all have many different interests all the time. Like your mind is never stopping. The same way Gemini suns are never restless, are always restless, always moving. Gemini Mercury, your mind is never ever stopping. So y'all taking information a lot. And y'all taking information better than most people. Understand that. So now saying this, because your mind is so quick, because y'all so intelligent, a lot of times the people around you can't really keep up with their mind. Gemini's minds is so quick-witted, and they're just taking so much information that the people around you that can't keep up, y'all get irritated with like slow people, with like no common sense type people, with people that don't really use their mind like that. Y'all get irritated with people that are slower than y'all. So having this energy, understand that if you're like in the lower level of a Gemini Mercury, like a lower, like a dark side of Gemini Mercury, you will use your power to like manipulate people. Y'all can really be good at like, you have a reputation for being like tricksters and jokesters, like using your mind and how smart y'all are to outsmart people and to like manipulate people and see what they could do. Like use your words to see how they react. Like y'all could really be like tricksters with your words and all that, because like y'all so talented with words and communication. Like that's really like a big strong point for y'all. Information, communication, words, analyzing things, just being like a jack of all trades, doing a lot of different interests, just always doing something, learning about something, grasping something, is a big like is a big plus for y'all. Understand that people around you sometimes they can't keep up. So y'all can be susceptible, if you're not in the high vibration Gemini Mercury, to manipulate people with your words, to play like mind games. Like y'all have a reputation for being like playing mind games with people, just trying to like see how they react by the things you say, just playing like little games, like with their mind, because your mind is extremely intelligent. Understand that. Nikola Tesla, keep that in mind. Like he really like set a mark for like technology, for like a lot of things with his mind and how intelligent he is. So he's not only intelligent, he's also great at speaking too. Like the way that y'all speak, because words are just, there's so many words jumbled up in your head, but y'all know how to like filter it out with Mercury in a fast way, because remember Mercury is extremely fast and Gemini is extremely fast. So like y'all could filter out words extremely fast and present it in like a flawless way. Like y'all so talented with like words. A good profession for y'all is like, especially like rapping. Look at like Andre 3000, like Tupac. Like they really know how to put words together and like express it out in a way that you probably never heard before. Like Andre 3000 is like a perfect example, the way he like raps really fast. Y'all can really talk really fast too. Like y'all just like, and when somebody's talking to you really fast, you're not gonna be like, wait, can you say that again? I can't understand it. It's like y'all talk really fast sometimes, and y'all can really understand people that talk fast, because like when things come in your head, it computes extremely fast, because Mercury is exalted here. Mercury loves being in Gemini. Mercury just loves taking that information. So understand that y'all are always thirsty for information. That's why y'all like being around people that are also thirsty for information. Like being around people that are also able to bounce off ideas with, because y'all love to like brainstorm. Y'all just love to use your mind, like just talk and like think about ideas, even gossip for the females, even some men too, but like y'all like to just bounce off ideas with people around you. So you need to surround yourself around people that are open-minded, people that are not slow. When I say slow, I just mean like people that also like to take in information, people that have common sense, because like there's nothing more annoying to a Gemini Mercury person than somebody that does not have common sense, that does not like use their brain, basically, because y'all brains are so advanced. Understand that air sign energy is intelligence, water sign energy is intuition, earth sign energy is practicality, and fire sign energy is like adrenaline, or it's like action, it's like in your face kind of thing, it's like action basically. So the intelligence factor for Gemini Mercury people is extremely high. So that's why y'all are really always doing something with your mind. You're always having an interest. You're always doing something. You're never resting. You're never like sitting there not doing nothing. A lot of times your mind never shuts off, even when you're laying down. Gemini suns can even relate to this, but Gemini energy in general just never stops. Understand that it's ruled by Mercury. Mercury is the fastest planet of the solar system. Mercury and Gemini, their mind just never ever stops. So to like really keep up with these people, you want to be the type that you could like, are open-minded, like I said, the type to always want to take in information. You want to be the type to like just love to communicate. Communication is key for Gemini Mercury people. They need to know that you are able to use your words and communicate effectively to get the point across. They don't like people that are like really like closed off with their words, closed off with their communication. They don't want to figure things out how you feel. They want you just to tell them, like, use your words and like express yourself, because they're really good at expressing themselves. If you're like if you're a Taurus, now remember, if Gemini does not, Mercury does not like to move too far away from the sun. So if you're a Taurus sun, or a Gemini sun, or a Cancer sun, you're gonna have a Gemini Mercury. You have a Gemini Mercury. You have a Taurus sun, Cancer sun, or Gemini sun. So if you're a Taurus sun with a Gemini Mercury, you're gonna be less stubborn, slightly less stubborn, because I ain't gonna say all that less stubborn shit, but you're gonna be slightly less stubborn and slightly less rigid, because like Gemini is open-minded. So you're gonna be able to like be also open-minded a little bit more with the Taurus energy. If you're a Gemini sun with a Gemini Mercury, you're gonna be like a super Gemini. You're gonna be like super sane Gemini type shit. Like Gemini energy is gonna flow through you. You're gonna be extremely sociable, extremely like, you're gonna always be doing something, bouncing around. You're gonna be very like, people gonna love talking to you. You're gonna be always like sociable to the max kind of thing. Your communication skills is gonna be like OD to the max. If you're a Cancer sun with a Gemini Mercury, you're gonna be able to communicate your feelings better than a regular Cancer, because Cancers generally are emotional. Cancers generally have mood swings, so they go through like moon changes. So having a Mercury in Gemini will help y'all to like communicate your feelings, how you feel, more effectively. So understand that, like I said, having this energy, you could be susceptible to manipulating people because of how intelligent your mind is. Now, Gemini's are twins. Gemini is two energies put together, duality. So Gemini Mercury men and Gemini Mercury women, they think like a man and a woman at the same time, if that makes sense. They have the ability to really think like a man if they're a woman, or to think like a woman if they're a man, or opposite, vice versa. This is why they could always outsmart people, because they could think both ways, duality. They have the capacity to really like, really outwit you with their word. Their wit is quick as hell. Like they could really know how you are. They can really watch you and observe you, and they can really peep you. And if they want to, they can get what they want through how they talk and what they say. So if you're around these people and you're not smart, if you're not able to keep up with them, understand that you're gonna be more susceptible for them to finesse you, or to like to outsmart you if you're not able to keep up with how fast Gemini's Mercury's mind are. So they need to be around people like them. Like, you need to be around people that can really keep up with y'all, because otherwise you're gonna be bored quick as hell. Like, y'all get bored quick as hell. Mercury sign, the Mercury sign is like, you will feel your Mercury sign even more stronger than your Sun sign sometimes, because that's how you think. So you're gonna think like a Gemini. You're gonna think like you are a Gemini. You're gonna think and analyze like a Gemini. So that boredom is even like more susceptible for y'all, because like, your mind is always working. If you're around people that are not moving as fast as you, it's like your mind is working and their mind is just staying still. They're not really like helping you like stimulate your mind or anything. So you get like really, really bored. Y'all could watch like movies and already know the plot, already know what's gonna happen. Like, y'all mind is just so advanced like that. Remember, air sign is intelligence. Air sign Mercury. Mercury is the fastest planet. Mercury loves being in air signs. Mercury knows how to communicate. Geminis love to communicate. This is like the perfect position if you want to be any kind of profession that use your communication, like radio, a talk show host, like YouTube channel, obviously, anything that use your communication, anything that use your words will really benefit y'all in the long run. Like, that's really a good profession for y'all, using your communication skills, because your communication skills is A1. Understand that. Now, we already know Gemini energy is a very curious energy. It's like the child of the zodiac. Children are always very curious, asking questions. So because of this, your mind is very curious about life, about everything, no matter where you go. So this is why you're going to always want to grasp information. You're going to always want to take in information. So my suggestion for y'all is to, like, because your mind is always taking information, make sure y'all write things down so you don't forget it. Because, like, your mind is, like I said, will never stop. So when you're, like, studying things or just learning things, write things down so you never forget it. Because, like, y'all have the capacity to just, like, intake information. And y'all the type, too. It's funny. Y'all just come out of nowhere and spit out, like, fun facts or, like, just any, like, random-ass information. Like, just, like, random information. Like what year was the first car created. Like, random information that y'all just take in and just, like, remember. Gemini, Mercury are the jack of all trades but a master of none. And this is because they just love to take in so much information. They love to do so many different things. Multitasking kings, multitasking queens. They're the jack of all trades. Like, they'll learn something, and right before they get to mastery level, they'll get bored low-key and go to another interest, and then they'll learn a lot about that. And right before they get to mastery level, they'll get bored and go to something else. Like, they're always, like, learning something to the tip before they get to the mastery level. Their patience does not, like, really... They're actually very impatient, so their patience does not allow them to, like, really follow through 100% on that one thing before they move on to something else. And then they'll learn about that, and they'll learn about that quickly because their mind is very intelligent. So y'all are always, like, the jack of all trades, master of none. Y'all are always putting your hand in different baskets. Y'all are always learning something, studying something, intaking information, sharing information, talking to people about information. Y'all are like computers low-key. Air signs are like the computers of the zodiac, like computers to the max. But Mercury, Gemini especially, because Mercury moves so fast, Gemini moves so fast, this is like a perfect position for y'all if you want to be like any profession that use your words, like I said, any communication profession. So like communication majors, if you're in college, like that's definitely your forte. Anything that use your words and you speak and present yourself to people is A1 for y'all. Y'all have a way to speak clearly, to speak your words and like effectively. Y'all like to really watch people, what they do, and you can really analyze them quickly. Like, everything about your mind is quick. I bet like when y'all sleeping, your mind doesn't even stop. You're always like laying on the bed and your mind is not stopped. So like, you can't even go to sleep unless you have like the TV on, music in the background. Something else has to stimulate your mind constantly. Gemini, Mercury's minds have to constantly be stimulated. Like, even more than a Gemini sun, understand that, because your mind is how you think. So to be around these people, you need to stimulate their mind. They have to have stimulation in their mind. They have to be learning something around you. They have to be brainstorming around you. They have to be sharing something, talking to you about something, even gossiping low key. Like, they have to be just like, their Mercury has to come out. Their speech has to come out. Their words have to come out. Mercury and Gemini people need to stimulate their mind and share information with the world. So understand that. This is an exalted placement. This is a very comfortable placement for Mercury. Use this to your advantage, knowing your whole chart as well, but knowing that you have a Gemini Mercury, be like, all right, so boom, my communication skills are A1. I'm going to put myself in a position, whatever job I have, whatever business I want to start, I'm going to put myself in a position that I can use my talents, my Gemini Mercury, my A1 communication, my quick wit, my quick mind, my intelligent mind. I'm going to use my energy, my powers to like really benefit my life and propel me to the next level. Like, look at your chart, understand the energies y'all have, and use that in your real life to help you get where you want to go. It's that simple, which is why astrology, numerology, learning about yourself is extremely important, because it helps you in your reality life. It helps you in your real life. It helps you know what positions to put yourself that you'll be successful at, because you know your strengths and you know your weaknesses. So that's my video on Gemini Mercury. Hope y'all enjoyed that. My next video is going to be on Cancer Mercury. My next video is going to be on Mercury and Cancer. You already know I'm about to go in. If y'all subscribe to my channel, appreciate all y'all for real. You already know. If you haven't subscribed yet, go ahead and handle that one time for your boy. Drink your water. Mind your business and be safe out here. It's your boy Lil Finesse Jiggy Hippie. I'm going to see y'all when I see y'all.